exclusive coverage of Sri Lanka versus Bhutan 2018 World Cup qualifier match. Sorry for the delay in commentaries. I'm Navod Vijayvikrama. 3 minutes on, both teams still finding their feet. I'll just go through Sri Lanka team sheet. It's at the back, it's three at the back with Subhash Madhushan, Thilinda Suran, the Bandar, and Tharindu Ranga as three centre backs, with Sujan Perera as the custodian. And in midfield, it's Mohammed Rifnaz, Nalaka Roshan, the vice captain, Samir Sajid, Sanjeev Idrisuria, as forwards is it's Madhushan De Silva and Chaturanga Sanjeev. I'm sorry, that's Shanmugaraj Sanjeev. As the first strike on goal, that's off target by Bhutanese number 6. Sorry, that's Bhutanese number 8, Karma Shedrup, their captain. For Bhutan, it's Man Bahadur, Jigme Shering, Chenchu Karma Shedrup, Ugyen Doji, Karma Niduk, Shering Doji, Biren Basnet, Hari Gurung, and Lenduk Doji. Sorry if I'm pronouncing these names incorrectly. Long ball into the box by Sri Lanka. Easily gathered by goalkeeper Hari Gurung of Bhutan. Bhutan ranked 209th in the world. There's no one below them. Only 209 football playing nations. Sri Lanka ranked 172nd. There is a strong Bhutanese supporters here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Making their voices heard. Most of them are students studying here in Sri Lanka. Conditions for the Bhutanese, this hot weather here in Sri Lanka, almost 35, 36 degrees or even more. Sri Lanka, and for Bhutan, these alien conditions for them coming from high altitude country like Bhutan, high above the sea level. Goalkeeper Sujan Perera. Sujan Perera to Tharindu Ranga. Ranga with another long ball. Searching for Nalaka Roshan. But it's too much. Gathered by Hari Gurung. Sajid Kumara, Sri Lanka's defensive midfielder, heads it away. lot of misunderstanding between Subhash Majusthan and Sujan Pereira. They are almost costing them a goal. One was thinking other one would come and clear it, but neither one came. Kavind Ishan with the ball. Sanjeev with the chance. Dangerous play by Shanmugaraj. Sanjeev putting in a high boot. Free kick awarded to Bhutan. The Bhutan crowd here in full voice. Flank cleared away for a throw-in. The first part of the game going to Bhutan. Both teams are still struggling to find their feet. It's very hot weather. Even I am feeling it from this, from the commentator's box. Tries to curl that in at the near post, but it goes over for a goal kick. It was taken by Biren Basnet. Tarinder Ranga with the ball. Goes to Nalaka Roshan. Nalaka Roshan to Subhash Majusthan. In midfield, Rifnas with the ball. Puts it to Kavind Ishan. The man with the space. Puts it across into the box. But it goes over Majusthan De Silva. Very well headed away by the Bhutan defense. It was taken by Biren Basnet. Tarinder Ranga with the ball. Past the defender. Goes to Nalaka Roshan. Nalaka Roshan to Subhash Majusthan. And he's awarded a free kick. In midfield, Rifnas with the ball. Puts it to Kavind Ishan. The man with the space puts it across into the box. But it goes over Majusthan De Silva. Very well headed away by the Bhutan defense. I'm here joined by in commentary Sabir Kader. Sabir, what are your thoughts about the match so far?
It's the first free kick now Sri Lanka had, but well defended by Bhutanese. So far, it's like Nawood said, it's been quite hot here out at Sugandasa Stadium.
Puts
still
it to
humid, Ishan, rather.
The man with the space.
And
puts it across
position
into the
wise, Bhutanese are playing quite a lot in the Sri Lankan half.
Majusthan De Silva.
And
very well headed away by the Bhutan defense.
And Sri Lanka on the other hand,
two chances
so far. So far, it's like Nawood said, it's been quite hot here at the Sugandasa Stadium. Still humid,
man with the space.
And
the
position wise, Bhutanese are playing quite a lot in this game.
Another very good defense. Warm welcome to you all here. Join us.
First, Bhutanese.
Rifnas. Rifnas goes past one. Tries to put in through ball. This time Madhushan drives the shot on the goal. It's over the crossbar. Running like 30-40. Bhutan fans here at the Sukhothai Dance Stadium making their noise heard. Bhutan players would really love this. They would be feeling the heat, but the cheering of the fans would really help them, isn't it, Sabu?
Absolutely. The atmosphere behind the commentary box is electrifying. There's so much Bhutan supporters, not 30 or 40, probably more now. And also they're going like each cheer after cheer, one cheer from Sri Lanka and then counter cheer by the Bhutan is quite amazing and electrifying. So on the field, Sri Lanka had third corner, but they could not convert into a goal. Great defending by the men in white so far. Surely they must be feeling the warm weather here. Like Nawad said earlier, Bhutan is quite above the sea level and altitude-wise. So we can see that referee is having a word. There's a probably a niggle on the knees. That sharing Dorji on the field. Sri Lanka had not really comfortable with his knee. He could not convert into a goal. Great defending by the men in white.
Yeah, he's
so
really
far
suffering, and surely they must be
beating
the
warm weather
sooner,
here.
Sooner rather than later.
Like Nawad said earlier, Bhutan is quite above the sea level and altitude wise.
His hands are a bit.
So we can see that referee is having a word.
Drive. Always difficult for the keeper to gather those on the bounce.
That sharing Dorji
on the field. Sri Lanka had
not really comfortable with his knee.
Could not convert into a goal.
Great defending by the men in white.
He's
so
really
far
suffering, and surely they must be beating
the
warm weather here.
Sooner rather than later.
Sanjeev,
like
captain,
earlier,
another through ball.
Bhutan
beautiful passing. Rifnas puts in a through ball. A bit too much, but the defense does really, really well.
We can see that referee is having a word.
Drive. Always difficult for the keeper. Number two, that's Mahan Bahadur Gurung, clearing that away for corner. Wonderful defending there, and wonderful bit of play by Sri Lanka. That's the first time they've put in a few passes and made it into the box.
Absolutely, I can see Rifnas and Madhushan have been great threats. They are playing with really good awareness and understanding between them. And this time the corner, well saved. But Sri Lanka with the ball. Sajid Kumara with the number 20, trying to dance between the Bhutanese. There goes Nalak Roshan, and Madhushan supports out wide. And once again, the ball goes into the touch. So Sri Lanka corner. Madhushan to throw in. Now the position.
That's a free kick given to Bhutan. Well, Sabir, the way the Bhutan players are playing, it seems as if there's no different, even though they are 209th ranked in the world and Sri Lanka 172nd. There's no difference. They are playing some brilliant football, even in this hot, humid sun.
Absolutely. Now, I don't think the ranking will affect that much in this once again. A free kick conceded by Sri Lankan defender. That's number 19. That's Nalak Roshan. And in fact, it's Tarindu Eranga who's going to be getting a yellow card. So the first warning for the Sri Lanka. That's to Tarindu Eranga. In fact, he's wearing number 23 jersey. So we'll see how Bhutan is going to attack on this set piece. I don't know whether you can hear the voice of the spectators. Too noisy at the back. That's a good kick. That is the post. That's quite unfortunate. That's Chencho with a lovely header, it hits the sidebar. Quite unfortunate, that was a huge threat.
That was an unbelievable, unfortunate for Bhutan. Sri Lanka goalkeeper Sujan Pereda was left stranded as he hit the near post upright, and then they had another chance from the 6-yard box, but it was well wide. Wonderful chance gone begging for Bhutan. It seems as if the weather is not affecting them one bit. Sajit Kumara puts in a ball to the left to the hard-working Madhushan De Silva, who puts in an early cross, but it's cleared away for a throw-in.
He should have crossed. It's equally well supported, but Bhutan is too quick in defense. Probably he could have taken into the box. Nawad Madhushan with the throw.
Indeed, Sabir, he had a lot of space, just one defender to beat. He should have come into the box and put in that cross. Nalak Roshan and Shanmugaraj Sanjeev not on the same wavelength. Not good defending by Sri Lanka there, conceding an easy, unwanted corner. That was Tarindu Eranga. You could hear the Bhutan fans cheering now.
And also now I can see the coach of Bhutan, he's also looking at the spectators and he couldn't believe this support and cheer.
Indeed, wonderful scenes here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Even the Sri Lanka fans are cheering the Bhutan, cheering. I must confess, Bhutan, you all have some wonderful fans. What do you think, Sabe?
Absolutely, indeed, indeed. Sri Lanka playing in the own half. Good pass. Unable to retain position. Sri Lanka with the throw-in. Shanmugaraj Sanjeev couldn't hold the ball, but Sri Lanka maintained. Madhushan with the quick throw. That's number 10, Chaturanga Sanjeev, the skipper. Now the ball going from left to right. There's Nalaka, number 19. He sends to the Eranga. Again to Nalaka. Nalaka looking for support. Sanjeev with the shoot, but it's too high.
A hopeful 30-yard effort by Sajit Kumara. He can strike the ball well, but this was well over the crossbar. Playing a 4-5-1 formation with Maan Bahadur Gurung, Jigme Shering, Karma Nidup, Dawa Jetsheng at the back with Hari Gurung as their goalkeeper, with Lendup Doji. This time Chaturanga Sanjeev from outside the box, a tame effort, layoff by Shanmugaraj Sanjeev. That was a tame effort by Chaturanga Sanjeeva. Kamid Ishan was hearing down on the right-hand flank. He should have passed to him. As I was saying, in midfield for Bhutan. There's Lindup Doji, Biren Basnet, Shering Doji, Ugyen Doji, and Captain Karma Shedrup. And as the lone forward, there's Chencho Jilsheng. From what I've heard, Chencho plays club football in Thailand. Correct me if I'm wrong, Bhutan fans. Karma Shedrup, a very young captain, age of 22. As he was saying at the press con yesterday, he said that the world ranking doesn't matter, it's what you do at the match on that particular day what matters. And up to now, they've played some brilliant football. 25 minutes have gone in this first half. It's been all Bhutan. It's going to be a long throw in by Tarinduwaranga. There is a contest by Chaturanga Sanjeeva, but well gathered by Harigurung. Harigurung has been calm and composed in this first half. Sri Lanka playing an, what they used to play in the Bangabandhu Trophy as well, with a 3-5-2 formation with Tarindu Eranga, Thirina Suranda Bandara, Subhash Madhushan at the back. And in midfield, there's Madhushan De Silva, Rifnaz Nipu, Sajid Kumar at defensive midfield, Nalaka Roshan and Kavindu Ishan at and in the front. There's Captain Chaturanga Sanjeev and Shanmugaraj Sanjeev. For Sri Lanka, in the last few matches they've played in the Bangabandhu Trophy as well, has been their forward line who hasn't been scoring well, but their defensive lines have been pretty good, as Sajid Kumara puts in a brilliant tackle, goes out for a throw-in. Man Bahadur puts in a long ball, but it's well wide, goes out for a goal kick. Sabir, how do you rate the Bhutan playing so far?
So far, they have been a huge threat. They had one great chance from the their playmaker Chen Cho from the set piece, and his header was hitting the sidebar, unfortunately. Now Sri Lanka with the ball, captain trying to put a bit into the Sri Lanka somehow again giving the ball position away. Now defending have to be sort. Talking about the bench strength, what do you think, Nawud?
Well, for Sri Lanka, they have very good bench strength in Mohammad Zarwan Johar, who went to Manchester United for a training as well. He's a really good player, good forward. He's very young in age. He's just 21 years old. And there's always Uday Shanaka. Asiku Rahuman in defense. And also Nipun Bandar, who plays for Air Force, who is also a very good player. And for Bhutan, in the substitute bench, there's Gawang Jamfel, their substitute goalkeeper, Dan Bahadur Biswa, Ugyen Sheteng, Lungtok Dawa, Divash Subha, Shering Dendup, Shimi Doji. Sonam, Kuenga, Thinlay, Kesang, Wangdi, Karangurung.
Once again, Sanjeeva with the ball in the far right corner. Good ball inside. Now into the box. Once again, ball coming off from the Bhutani player. Now Bhutan is on the counter attack. The forward Chencho is looking for the ball, whether it's going to come through the airbound. Chencho once again into the box. Chencho shoots, it goes wide. Wide, well over the post. So he has been the huge threat so far for the men in white. Now Sri Lankan goalkeeper sends it to the defender.
This is for all you Sri Lanka football fans. www.thepapari.com is the official web partner for the Kargil's Food City FA Cup. You can catch all the match reports, results, news, photos on Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, www.thepapari.com. For photos, you can always log into the papari.com Facebook page. That's thepapari.com. You can search on the Facebook page and find the photos there. For match results, reports, you can always log into www.thepapari.com. Almost 35 minutes gone. Subhash Madhusan with the throw in. Shanmugaraj, Sanjeev. Sanjeev to Rifnas. Rifnas to Kamideshan. Lapse in concentration in defense by Bhutan, allowing Shanmugaraj Sanjeev to take a shot, but it's a very tame one. Goes off the Bhutan defense for a corner. Crossbar again, and the headed back by Chaturanga Sanjeeva. Well saved. So the crossbar and the upright coming to the rescue of both the teams. Firstly, it was for Sri Lanka, then now for Bhutan. It was a powerful header initially off the crossbar again. As Sujan Pereira was stranded, this time Hari Gurung was also stranded off the crossbar and headed back in again by Sri Lanka captain Chaturanga Sanjeeva. Very well saved by Hari.
Sri Lanka had third corner, but they could not convert into a goal. Great defending by the men in white so far. So once again, another
surely they must be
feeling the warm weather here. Like Nawad said earlier, Bhutan is quite above the sea level and altitude wise. Shearing Doji to take the kick.
So we can see that referee is a huge kick.
Probably it's almost outplayed the Sri Lankan goalkeeper Sujan. The kick was way into the post almost, but well saved at the end.
That was a brilliant free kick by Shearing Doji. It almost reminded me of Ronaldinho back in 2002 when he chipped over David Seaman of England. Sujan Pereira was way off his line and at the last minute only palmed it away for a corner. Almost a brilliant goal there. This time headed away by Shanmugaraj Sanjeev. Put out by Chaturanga Sanjeeva. That was a brilliant thinking by Shearing Doji. Bhutan number 16. He surely must have been watching those Ronaldinho free kicks, Sabir.
Yeah, I do remember that. I was just going to say that was a brilliant piece of skill, the world-class Ronaldinho. So there you go, Bhutan once again. This time around, goalkeeper Sujan makes it easy. Talking about the height factor, especially taking in the corner now, both the teams looking, probably Sri Lankan looks a bit taller than the Bhutanese.
Well, some of them, but when you look at the Bhutan defense, Sabir, there is one guy who's that's number four, that's Digme Shering, who is, I think, the tallest. For Sri Lanka, there is Rifnaz Nipu in midfield and Shanmugaraj Sanjeev at the forward line. Madhushan De Silva, a first-time cross, trying to find Shanmugaraj Sanjeev. Sanjeev still tussling with the ball. Nalaka Roshan to Kavindu Ishan. The dynamic winger. Again, a poor cross in, but Nalaka Roshan, Rifnaz. Very well kept by that's number 8, Karma Shedrup. Unnecessarily giving in a free kick. He had the possession, but Sajid Kumara did really well to get that free kick. Nalaka Roshan stands over the ball. Nalaka Roshan is Sri Lanka's free kick specialist. I think in the last couple of games in Bangladesh, he hit the crossbar twice or thrice, Sabir. So unfortunate. It's a short free kick taken. Sri Lanka tried a set piece, a set move there, but Madhushan De Silva, their number 7, was not in the same wavelength. Ball goes back to Sujan to Thirina Bandara. Thirina Bandara is the elder brother of Nipuna Bandara. Nipuna Bandara is on the bench today. Kavindu Ishan to Sanjeev. Sanjeev again. Very well organized defense by Bhutan. Again, another miscommunication by Sri Lanka. Chencho is down. Shedrup feeds the ball to the right-hand flank. Number 20, finding Ledup Doji. Goes into the box, puts some skills. But put the ball across the goal, but it's cleared away. Chencho is still on the ground. Chencho is in need some help. I think the boot of Sujan Pereira caught Chencho's leg when Sujan Pereira came in to clear the ball. As the Bhutan players take this break in play to refresh themselves. Very hot day here in Colombo. Sujan Pereira.
So almost 40 minutes of play being played, and the scoreboard still nil-nil. Again with a chance, but the header goes a bit over the post. Again by Chencho. He has been devastating so far. So not too long for the halftime now.
Yes, Abir, just 5 minutes and a bit of extra time left. But it's all been Bhutan. So unfortunate. Just one chance for Sri Lanka. But it's, if you analyze the overall gameplay, it's all been Bhutan. Sri Lanka players look nervous at the start, and they are still nervous. They cannot put in a few good passes. Again, they are again Chaturanga Sanjeev misplacing a pass. They've been good in midfield, but when it comes to the attacking half, attacking third, they cannot seem to find that final telling pass, Sabir.
And also the, especially set-piece move, the free kick which they had, there were a bit lack of communication between the players and organizing. They didn't know. In fact, Madhushan on the left wing, he didn't know what will happen on that move.
Absolutely. Then that's Chencho getting a yellow card for not waiting for the referee's call to bring him back in. That's really bad from Chencho. He should have stayed back until the referee called him into play. Brilliant through pass to find him, Madhushan De Silva. Madhushan tries to put it in across, a bit too late. Two defenders have already come up to him. Again into the box, cleared away. Sajid Kumara with the ball. Puts in a through pass, finding Kavindu Ishan. Tries across, cleared away. For corner, Sajid Kumara to take it.
So it's another corner. Just to remind, just a referee from China, Fu Ming, is controlling the game very nicely. Here's the corner chance, again defended very well. And Roshan Nalakar's kick goes again to over the post.
First 45 minutes of this game, the Bhutan defense has been really, really good as Kavindu Ishan puts in the afterburners. Almost an own goal by Jigme Shering. So unfortunate if he had gone in for the Bhutan after playing all that hard work, doing all that hard work. Almost a freak own goal as Sajid Kumara comes to put in the corner kick, a low one. It goes out for another corner kick. As I was saying, the Bhutan defense has been really good. They've, from the onset, their defense has been settled, and that has allowed their midfield and the strikers to put the pressure on Sri Lanka, what Sri Lanka hasn't been able to do.
Also, it's good to see again the corner. Almost a chance, but then once again, it's good defensive by the visitors. So, but one good thing to see for the last 5 minutes of play, Sri Lanka have changed their gear from defensive mode to.
As I was saying, the Bhutan defense has been really good.
They are really threatening
from
now.
The onset,
they have been for the
their defense
inside
has
the
been
box
settled
few
and
times,
that has allowed
and
their
showing
and
some
the
great attack.
To put the pressure on Sri Lanka.
This is what you want to see, because scoreboard is still nil-nil. We are
also
not too far from the
half-time
corner. I'm sure there's loads of words from the coaches.
Almost a chance, but to be sent in the break.
Good defensive.
Maybe some white board and the marker comes to the play.
So, but
Sri Lanka once again with a chance. Madhushan sends it in. Rifnaz with the ball. And Rifnaz misses. Referee says play on. And the kick from Sajid Chamira, it goes once again over the post. So once again you witness threatening attacking play by the host, but all what they need to do is to be a bit composed and be a bit communicative. So far it's been a great last 10 minutes of play. So Bhutan on the attack in the Lankan half. Sajid Chamira, the ball, there goes Rifnaz, and he sends it to Kavindu, to the captain Sanjeeva, and the cross. Madhushan didn't have much work to be done because the ball is almost into the goal line. Hari Gurung to take on the kick, and it's going to be 2 minutes of additional time. in the first half, as we see. And again, Gurung coming and kicks the ball into touch. Safe play, but here goes Madhushan taking the quick throw, and that's Captain Sanjeev. But could not capitalize that move. Sri Lanka stay with the ball position, now send it to the left, but it was taken by Bhutan. There goes Chencho attacking. Chencho one-on-one, but referee calls for the foul play by Chencho. Controlling really nicely the game by the referee Fuming from China. Madhushan. Once again, ball into touch. Subhash Madhushan with the throw. Sorry, Rifnaz with the throw. And Chamira sends it to goalkeeper. That's a good kick. That's a good kick, and it was received by Sanjeev. And the ball goes, but Gurung is safe. No pressure for him. He was cool as a cucumber on this hot sun. And send it to Chencho. That's a brilliant kick. Chencho on charge. But the ball beat everyone. Chencho could not have another chance. Now Sri Lanka sends out the ball. A minute to the half-time. Captain Sanjeev touches. Rifnaz comes, but the ball position lost again. It was taken by Doji. Doji, the striker. And it was foul played by Doji. And that's it. That's the halftime whistle. Sri Lanka 0, Bhutan 0 so far. So the first quarter of this game being Bhutan is, they attack well, they hit one shot, one header to the post. But in the later half or the second quarter of the first half, Sri Lankan really dominated, especially going into Bhutan box and few corners. But still, overall, the game is still even, Steven. So, Nawod,
the winner of the first half, it's absolutely, that's Bhutan. Bhutan has, from the onset, they've been playing really well. Their defense line has been really strong, calm, composed. In the last quarter, I know, Sabir, Sri Lanka came into the game. They had one header off the crossbar. But other than that, it's all been Bhutan, who has played really well. The calm and composed nature of the Bhutan defense has loved their defense, their midfield actually, their midfield and their forward, Chencho, who has really threatened to score. He also had another chance which came off the upright, and another chance which he failed to convert from the 6-yard box. To all our Sri Lankan viewers, as I was saying early, www.thepapra.com is the official web partner for the Kargil's Food City FA Cup. We'll be live streaming the semi-finals and the finals of the Kargil's Food City FA Cup, and also we'll be covering the round 1, 2, 3 and up to the finals as well. Match reports, match results, as well as photos. You can log into www.thepapra.com for photos. You can always log into the Facebook page of www.thepapra.com. For all the Bhutan fans, here are your fans who has come in numbers with the flags, who has been the more vocal of the two sets and has been really the Papra.com for photos. You can always log into the Bhutan Facebook page players who are playing under this hot of www.thepapra.com. Really energy sapping sun. For all the Bhutan fans. Here are your fans who has come in numbers with the flags. We'll be back in another 10 minutes time. Who has been the more vocal? Join us for the second half of Sri Lanka versus really Bhutan. The Papadot 2018 World Cup qualifiers. We'll be back in 10 minutes time. Under this. Hello and welcome back to the second half live coverage on www.thepauper.com. Sri Lanka versus Bhutan, the 2018 World Cup qualifier. This is the furthest you can be away from Moscow in terms of qualification, of course. Today there will be another few qualification matches as well. Now the sun has gone behind clouds. Pretty cool weather right now. Bhutan players would love this weather to continue. As I am joined by Sabir Kader again for the second half as we kick off.
Nawada, what do you think, especially the halftime message by the coach? You also had the interview with the coach, Sri Lankan coach. What is this tournament is all about? Is it like giving him momentum, gaining experience?
Well, for Nikola Kavzovic, for the past few months, it's all been the preparation for this World Cup qualifier, because they are expected to win this and win this quite comfortably. Simply because Bhutan are ranked 209th in the world and Sri Lanka 172nd. But according to the first half performance, it isn't so. But however, Nikola Kavzovic wanted to win this and go into the next group stage qualifiers and not be placed in fourth or fifth place. That's their main target and in the future, because this is a very, very young squad. The average age of the Sri Lanka squad is 22. And also the Bhutan squad is also 22. After the SAF debacle in 2013, Sri Lanka completely overhauled their squad as well as their coach and brought in a very young squad. There's only one or two players who are over the age of 25. Sri Lanka completely overhauled their squad as well as their coach and brought in a very young squad.
We hope you're all enjoying the live coverage brought to you by www.thepauper.com. This is one of the first football matches that we have been showing. Second, rather. After the one big final in the Sri Lankan schools sector. And we are so glad there's more than 1,000 viewers watching online right now all over the world. So it's another good sign for us.
A special shout out to all the Bhutan fans joining from way back in Bhutan. Hope you all are enjoying the coverage. As again the Bhutan fans are making their voices heard. Ball goes out. Sri Lanka with a throw-in. Sajid Kumara with the ball. Chaturanga Sanjay puts in a ball to Mazhandi Silva. Sajid Kumar again tries to cross it in, but well cleared, well blocked. Now a lot of pressure must be on the Sri Lankan shoulders, Sabir, because this is their home game. They need to win by a few good goals. Now, simply because they would have to play in alien conditions back in Bhutan, high altitude match, very low temperatures, which the Sri Lankans aren't used to. As Madhushan De Silva tries to weave himself past, brilliant tackle there. So if Bhutan can get a draw here, they would be firm favourites going into the second leg back in Bhutan. Long throw in by Subhash Madhushan. Shanmugaraj Sanjeev tumbles down. Goal kick given.
And talking about the first half, there's two very good threats for especially the remarkable play by Chencho Bhutani, number 7. He had quite two opportunities. One, of course, hit the post. And from Sri Lankan perspective, Rif Khan and Madhushan, Dhananju Madhushan on the left wing, who had been a star so far. He has pace, he has skills, he curves the ball in, but just couldn't make the accurate touches.
Then Mat Samaga Ekathu Wenawa. Hitapu Sri Lanka Pila Kridaka Wagema Nayaka Sumit Walpola. Sir, the Papra.com wenin piligannawa. Sir, palamen pasanna Sri Lanka Kandayame Palumbage Kridaka Vilasaya Pilibanda.
Palumbage Krida Vilasaya Baluwama Degollama Samasama Krida Karana. Namuth Krida Vilasaya Baluwama Nepal Bhutan Krida Bhutan Kandayama පොඩක් ඉදිරියෙන් සෙල්ලම් කරනවා. ඒකට හේතුව බූටාන් කණ්ඩායමේ සෙල්ලම් කරන ක්‍රීඩකයෝ කුඩා කල සිටම වයස 13 සිටම එකටම ක්‍රීඩා කරන කණ්ඩායමක් වශයෙන් මම දන්නවා. මොකද මම මේ කණ්ඩායම බූටාන් අය සමග වයස 13න් පහළ, 14න් පහළ, 15න් පහළ, 16න් පහළ වගේ කණ්ඩායම් සමග ගිහිල්ලා තියෙන නිසා මේ මෙතන සෙල්ලම් කරන ක්‍රීඩකයෝ ගොඩක් දෙනෙක් මම අඳුරනවා. ඒක නිසා මේගොල්ලෝ කණ්ඩායමක් හැටියට ඒගොල්ලෝ අපේ කණ්ඩායමට වැඩිය පොඩ්ඩක් ෆස්ට් ප්‍රථම භාගයේ පොඩ්ඩක් එකමුතු ක්‍රීඩා කරා.
That was former Sri Lanka captain Sumit Walpola saying that these Bhutanese players have been playing together from the under 13 age groups as well, so they have a better understanding, and that's why they've been playing, they've played really well in the first half. Sumit, can you tell what changes should the Sri Lankans make in the second half?
I think they should bring Jarwan into the middle. Then I think Jarwan is a super player. He's a ball player and a ball skill player. He knows most of the player, this Bhutan players. So I think if he comes to the center, we can do something, because he's a master of skill player.
Indeed, Jarwan is a very skillful player. As Bhutan gets a corner out of it. Sir, what do you think coach Kavasavic would have said to the Sri Lankan players?
I think he's trying his best, because we can't blame him also, because this is a new Sri Lankan team, very young outfit. Only one or two players, the experienced players are playing. The Bhandara from behind, he's play experienced player. All the others are same as Bhutan players, because I know most of the players, they went with the Nepal to play some tournaments with the Nepal in Bhutan players. So I think he might do some change, I'm definitely sure, because they are warming up five players. I think definitely they will change Jarwan into the middle in, I think, another 5 minutes or 10 minutes time.
Absolutely, the words from former Sri Lanka player and captain Sumit Walpole is that they should bring in Zarwan, that dynamic midfield player who can weave in some magic and put some impetus into the Sri Lanka game. As Subhash Madhusan clears that away. Again, so talking about the Bhutan players, their defense has been really good from the first half itself. So can you tell us what do you think about the Bhutan defense? It has been really good in the first half as well.
A little bit solid they are playing, but our strikers are, they are trying their best. They are trying, but only thing is our strikers are spoiling the scoring chances. That's the problem, because their understanding is more better than our Sri Lankan players. So their goalkeeper also not bad, because he saved 2-3 goals in first half also. I think we can't blame to the strikers also. Due to this climate also, very effective to the players also. So I think Sri Lanka might score in during another 10 minutes time, definitely.
And as he says, almost a chance for Sri Lanka. Chaturanga Sanjeev tries overhead kick, easily gathered by Hari Gurung. Sri Lanka goalkeeper Sujan Pereira comes way off his line to clear that ball. And as I say, I thank Mr. Sumit Walpole for sharing his thoughts in commentary, and all the best, sir.
Yes,
could see on the sideline Zarwan Joe, as coach Sumit Walpole said, and Nipuna Bandara warming up. Sabir, it's the same playing style that has been in the first half as well. In the second half, there's nothing much has changed. Bhutan has been really solid in defense.
Absolutely, Nawud. There's not much rotation between the ball. It has to go from right to left and make the Bhutan is a bit more run, because we are talking about the weather early on, and this is another good move, but unfortunately it was offside. Referee's flag, assistant referee's flag straight up. That was the right wing Sanjeev off to the ball. It was a good pass, actually. He saw the space. Unfortunately, it was offside. So it's a chance for Bhutanese. Goalkeeper comes into the attack. Now that is insane. Proper chance for the Bhutanese, as Lindup Dorji, he was coming, the goalkeeper is not standing where he used to be. He was
Sanjeev
going for the ball.
Off to the ball.
He was out
it
of the box and he can't handle the ball with the hands.
He saw the space.
That's a good cross kick by Bhutani number 20.
Zero.
That's Dava. But the opportunity
it's
went
a
begging for
Bhutanese. Goalkeeper comes
in. They need
that
a bit more support now.
Bit more numbers
that is
in the
insane.
Box.
Proper
it would
chance
have been
for the Bhutanese.
So anyway,
as Lindup Dorji has been played in the second half, the scoreboard
he was
still
coming,
stands.
The
nil goalkeeper
all
is not
so
standing
once again,
where he
another
used to be.
Offside
he was
conceded
by the
Lankans.
To the ball.
He was out of the box and he can't handle the ball with his hands.
The space. That's a good cross kick by Bhutan in number 20. Sir. That's Dhawan.
There is going to be a change in the Sri Lanka lineup.
But the opportunity went big for Bhutan. His goalkeeper comes in.
They need a bit more
Zarwan
support.
Is ready to come back in as coach Sumit Palpala said. He said in another 5-10 minutes time they would take it. As Madhushan Lisira takes too much time
in the second half. The scoreboard.
He tries to control it.
Keeper is not
without firing. On the volley, the Bhutan defense clears that away.
Out of the box and
and on the other side, Chenchoy has a chance.
It's a good cross kick by Bhutan.
This time, Tarun Duranga. There is going to be a change.
Makes no mistake.
Clears that away again. Madhushan Lisira with the ball. It's end-to-end stuff.
They need a bit more support.
Zarwan is ready to come back in. Brilliant bit of football here at the Sukhothai Dasa Stadium. Fight in the 2018 World Cup qualifier between Bhutan and Sri Lanka.
Played in the second half. The scoreboard.
Chaturanga Sanjay with the ball. Kavindu Ishan. Without firing. Kavindu Ishan. On the volley. Showing his pace. Tries to go down, clears pass one. Passes back in Alaka Roshan.
Chenchoy has a chance.
As the Bhutan crowd comes alive. This time, Tarun Duranga. Alaka Roshan. No mistake. Clears the Tarun Duranga. Tarun Duranga. Puts in a wonderful curling kick, but straight at Hariguru. There is going to be a double change for Sri Lanka. Cup qualifier between Bhutan and coach Nikola Kavasavich is not at all pleased with the way Sri Lanka has been playing. And Chenchoy with the chance. It's too much and Sujan Pereira comes off his lines and saves it. End to end stuff, epic battle here at the Sukhothai Dasa Stadium.
Absolutely, now this game is becoming so much intense, so much energy, so much attacking. Chincho had one more chance despite the fact he hit one of these headers to the post in the early on first half.
Not at all pleased with the way Sri Lanka.
So here comes a replacement, like Nao said, two good players.
It's too much. That's a number eight. Comes off his lines and saves it. That's Sajid Zarwanjoy replacing number 20, Sajid Kumara. And Shambhurat Sanjeev coming out and is replaced by Nipuna Bandara. So the two Bandara brothers are there. Curling team, Suranda Bandara at centre back and Nipuna Bandara.
Despite the fact he
at centre forward.
Headed to the post in the early on first half.
Not at all pleased with the way Sri Lanka.
So here comes a replacement, like Nao said, two good players.
It's too much. That's a number eight. Comes off his lines and saves it. Zarwan, a proud product of Zahira College.
Number 20, Sajid
Sabit, my fellow commentator, is from Zahira College. He must be being proud.
Absolutely. If you're watching Zahira College, soccer has been the kings of football in Sri Lanka. No wonder, no doubt at all. They have produced many footballers to the proud nation.
Early on, first half.
Now, Zarwan with his first touch. That's a good pass. That cross. And that was a good kick, in fact, by the number 13, Kavindu Ishan, the right wing, and he is limping after that kick. That doesn't look good for the Sri Lankan. So the physio is waiting for the referee's call.
College soccer has been,
and Kavindu's injury looks like he's holding a cramp, maybe.
No doubt at all.
That would be a big blow after the double substitution. There's only one left.
Now they wouldn't want that's a good
an injury to Kavindu Ishan.
That was a good kick, in fact, by the number 13, Kavindu Ishan, the right wing, and he is limping off. Kavindu Ishan,
the dynamic winger.
That doesn't look good for the Sri Lankan.
And Nalak Roshan puts in a curling free kick into the box. Headed, but just wide.
The physio is waiting for the referee's call.
Header was by Subhash Madhushan.
Kavindu's injury looks like he's holding a cramp, maybe.
No doubt at all.
They have produced
that would be a big blow after the double substitution. There's only one left.
Now, they wouldn't want to. That's a good
an injury to Kavindu Ishan.
And that was a good kick, in fact, by the number 13, Kavindu Ishan, the right wing. And he is limping off.
Kavindu Ishan, the dynamic winger.
That doesn't look good for this.
Kavindu Ishan is back in the field again. There's a 3-on-1. Oh, brilliant. Brilliant.
Header
was covered defense by Subhash Madhushan. It was almost a 3-on-1.
Maybe.
With the goalkeeper to beat, but Subhash Madhushan backing up. There's only one save. A certain goal there.
That's a good
an injury to Kavindu Ishan.
And that was a good kick, in fact, by the number. number 13, Kalani Shandar, right wing. And he is limping off. Kalani Shandar,
dynamic winger.
Doesn't look good for this.
It's almost as if failed again. The Bhutan players have been playing in Sri Lanka for months. They said aren't affected by this heat, the humidity. It's almost a 3-1. They are doing all the talking here at the Sukhothalam Stadium. But Subhash Madhusudan.
Absolutely. Especially in the defending, they have been remarkable so far. And in the attack, they're just only one man in the front doing all the hard job. That's the Tencho, their number 7. In fact, Tencho is playing his club football in Thailand.
The Bhutan players have been playing in Sri Lanka.
For the information that we get, Bhutan is with the throw-in. That's number 11, Kama Nidup. Absolutely, especially in the defending, they still gain territory. So in the early second half, now Sri Lanka looks like have found some rhythm. They are rotating the ball. What they do is go to the opposite territory, take the ball with number 7, rotate the ball from right to left, find a space. He's playing, get the Bhutanese defenders moving and work tied to the post. So we saw one of the cross of Kavindu, which went almost to the goal post. It was a brilliant save by the goalkeeper. Absolutely, especially in the
first change done by Bhutan. So brilliant basket going off. And number 6, Lungtok Dawa coming in
front.
They've added a forward.
Go to the opposite territory. Take the ball with number 7.
After taking out a midfielder, Nipuna Bandara chases the ball.
Defenders moving.
Very well done by the tall defender.
So we saw
that's Jigmeh Shering heading it back to his goalkeeper Hari Gurung,
which went almost to the goalpost. It was a brilliant save by the goalkeeper.
So the Bhutan coach Chokri Nima sensing that he can get a win out of it and putting in another forward. 6 that's Lungtok Dawa coming in
front.
They've added a forward.
Go to the opposite territory.
Back into the field.
Number 7.
After taking out a midfielder, Nipuna Bandara giving some support.
Defenders moving
to Chencho. Well done by the tall defender.
So we saw
that's really, really good. Getting it back to for Bhutan, Bahari Gurung,
which went almost to the goalpost. It was a brilliant save by the goalkeeper.
So the Bhutan coach Chokri Nima, first sensing that he can get a win out here, is packed behind us. 6 that's Lungtok Dawa coming in
front.
They've added a forward.
Go to the opposite territory.
Back into the field.
Number 7.
After taking out a midfielder, Nipuna Bandara giving some support.
Defenders moving
to Chencho. Well done by the tall defender.
So we saw
that's big
man.
He comes off in lines and clears the way. Bahari Gurung, Sri Lanka playing a high defensive line.
It was a brilliant save by the
almost going through one goal. Chokri Chaturanga Sanjeeva sensing that he can get a win out here. Arindu Aranga again misjudging. He hasn't had a great game, Sabir.
They've
added a forward.
Go to the opposite territory.
Back into the field.
Number 7.
After taking out a midfielder.
Yes, the defender have been tested a few times by especially the number 7, Tencho of Bhutan. He also Tarinda had a yellow card in the first half. And the ball goes with the deflection. But goalkeeper Sujan sends out to the halfway mark. Naluk Roshan with the ball. He sends out to Subhash Madhusudan. Madhusudan with the ball, looking for support.
After taking out a midfielder.
Yes, Sri Lanka now moving on. Defender have been tested. That touch is by especially a bit wavered, but it was going into touch. Sri Lanka still capitalized the ball. Now we can see the coach is clearly into the
and the ball
position where coach can be allowed, and he's giving the instruction now.
But coach Nikola Kavinovich won't be pleased with Sri Lanka. He's committing too much players forward.
Naluk Roshan with the ball. He sends out to Subhash Madhusudan.
Players forward without just only Naluk Roshan. Up in midfield. Who has all the work as Nipuna Bandara with the ball. Cuts back in.
But it was going into touch.
The ball to Zarwan. Zarwan to
Karindu Aranga.
Karindu Aranga again.
Where coach can be allowed and he's giving the instruction now.
His head up. Chaturanga Sanjeev puts in an simple. Nothing Sri Lanka shot into the box. Too much players forward.
Look at the numbers now. There's five Sri Lankans inside the box. Once again, the chance goes. for the midfield. Goal post now. It's a corner. Early on the move, Sri Lankan had five numbers in the box, whereas Bhutan had only four. So it should have taken into the box. That's where they are missing. Where coach can be allowed, and he will see how this corner going to be. And that's a real tester for the Bhutani defenders. Kick all of Sri Lanka, capitalize the position. Now it's a corner. Once again, ball comes into the box. Madhushan this time has numbers. He was trying to get a bicycle out kick into the box. But the ball beats him. So it's a goal kick. Good aggression, good determination coming forward into the opposite territory. But what Sri Lanka is missing is that finishing touch.
Shot, and it was easily cleared away by Bhutan. They had
hasn't been much communication between the players, and it's so unfortunate because there have been some good chances in the second half for Sri Lanka. Puts in a ball to Kavindu Ishan. Kavindu Ishan with his pace goes into the box, but it goes out of him for a goal kick. Very well defended there. Kavindu Ishan can be a nippy customer. He has pace. He could put the ball behind you and burn you for pace.
That's right. Now, like you said, Sri Lanka had many chances in the second half, and also in position wise they are holding on to the position quite well than the first half, but position won't be counted at last. The score what matters. So there's not a lot of threat coming from Bhutan, because we can see only Chincho, number 7, is playing in the front as the main striker. So here's Zaram with the touch. Was it a foul? The play is down, but the referee says play on. That's good bit of refereeing. But now he comes. Maybe he got the call from the assistant. Maybe the fingers, hands could have touched.
That's Karan Shedrup down on the ground, the Bhutan captain. Sri Lanka is about to make their third and final change. Fazal Mohammed is going to replace Madhushan De Silva. Fazal is also a proud product of Zahira College. He will join Rifnaz Nipu, Zarwan Johar, all three from Zahira College. Sabir, you must be a really, really proud man now.
Absolutely, Nawud, absolutely. Good to see Zahirians in numbers in this team. And another threat coming by Chincho, but it was a goal kick. Great bit of defending by Thilina Suranda. Suranga Bandara, rather. He has 5-6 name on his that's Subhash. Sorry, Thilina Suranda Bandara Leonara Chige. That's quite a lot name.
Thilina Bandara playing at centre back. He played for the Sri Lanka Championship team, who won the Dialogue Champions League this time around. That's a solid football club all the way from Anuradhapura. He and Amit Kumar, who is on the bench today for Sri Lanka, had a brilliant partnership going on for solid. And that partnership really paved the way for Solid to win the Champions League here in Sri Lanka, as Nalak Roshan puts in a free kick. Curling one into the box. At the far post, a weak header by Chaturanga Sanjeeva. The vice captain searching out Chaturanga Sanjeeva. But he cannot head it into the goal. Wide of the far post. Time running out, and handball called against Bhutan. Quickly taken, Tarindu Eranga. Long ball into Fazal, but he cannot control it, and that goes out for a goal kick. Really poor touch by Fazal. Fazal, who is coming back from a injury, he's still recovering. but he's a good player who has a great vision. Hamid Ishan chasing the ball. He's almost out of energy by the looks of it, and tries to get a cheeky corner out of it, but the ball goes through the defender's leg. Much cooler weather here at the Sugathdasa Stadium now. Again, another poor pass by Rifnas. Too much power on it. The sun is hiding behind the clouds. The Bhutan players would warmly welcome this weather. The cool breeze flowing across the ground. Zarwan with the ball. Poor touch there again as he chases the ball down. Suranda Bandara. Nalak Roshan comes back in support, clears it away. The ball finds Nipuna Bandara, who goes into the box, tries a shot across the goal, but it's a tame one. Hari Gurung gathers it. Thirina Suranda Bandara has been doing all the defending work, working as the sweeper. Almost a goal, clear goal, and that's Bhutan's goal! Wonderful scenes here at the Sugathdasa Stadium. That's number 16. Shering Doji scoring for Bhutan. 1-0 Bhutan. Almost a few minutes away. From full time. Wonderful work there, Sri Lanka committing too much players forward and caught napping. Bhutan making use of the counter-attack, and they've been rewarded very well for their defensive work and the play. They've been playing really good football. They've come up with a plan, Sabit. And the Bhutan fans have come alive now. They're singing in full voice. Ishan with the ball, comes into the box, puts in a cross, well cleared by Bhutan. Again, Tharindu Eranga. Sloppy bit of work, conceding a free kick. The Bhutan player and Tharindu Eranga got into a tangle. Long ball in search of Chencho. Hamid Ishan with the ball. He goes in search of Fazal. Well cleared. Rifnas with the ball to Chaturanga Sanjeeva. Sanjeeva to Kavindu. Kavindu to Nipuna Bandara. Bandara to Eranga. To puts in a long ball again. A hopeful ball into the box. Nothing comes out of it. Again, now Bhutan are back in their numbers. Only one man. Oh, there are 10 men behind the ball, Sabir. They would be now defending their hearts out to keep this lead.
Absolutely. Here goes India attacking now. Just sent out the ball from their danger zone. Sri Lanka just could not capitalize all the possession they had. Especially Kamide Ishan had few run days, but his crosses, sometimes the ball went past him twice. So just could not get the finishing touch in the going into the box. Bhutan, on the other hand, they were playing so patiently. They had a great chances. They had some great chances in the first half. But what a goal that was to go up to the lead. We don't have much time left. And there goes Fazal with the touch. Send it to the captain, Sanjeev. And Tharendu with the ball. And he sends it out wide now. Looking for numbers. Sri Lanka got the ball once again. There was Kavindu with the ball. And again he could not get in control. He was going for the shoot, but it was not. He was in maybe two mind whether to take the ball and send it to the box again or just shoot. So he shoot just a soft touch. And the goalkeeper Gurung takes it easily. Tharendu Eranga sends the ball to Rifnaz. Rifnaz trying to find Kavindu. But Bhutan with the ball position now. That's Lendup Joji. But the ball goes to the touch. Huge cheer from the back, from the commentary box. The Bhutani fans are seeing their hearts out. Fascinating to watch. Sri Lanka, few minutes to go. There finds Zarwan, his header. And it looks like a handball and a yellow card. That yellow card is to the defender Shering Doji. But it was not a handball. So the goalkeeper Gurung to take the free kick.
To our Bhutan fans who are joining with www.thepapere.com, I'm sure you are enjoying this scoreline as well as the coverage. 1-0 to Bhutan. And if the score remains the same, they would be taking this advantage, the really big advantage into Bhutan. Playing in the second leg.
Bhutan is playing with so much confidence. If you look at the body language of their players, especially the goalkeeper Gurung, he is so much relieved with pressure. Eranga with the ball. Again, it's a touch. Throw ball again. So they need to play some really aggressive football in the last few minutes. We don't know how much, how many additional minutes going to be added. Sencho with the ball, but he gives it away. There goes Rifnarsen, is trying to find Fazal, and the ball was sent it to the touch by number 6. That's Luktok Dava, the goal scorer. Zarwan to Rifnaz. Rifran finds to Kavindu. That's another silly mistake. That's a silly giving away ball position. This shouldn't be the story for Sri Lanka. Bhutan leads 1-0.
The goal was scored by number 16, Shering Doji, after some wonderful work down on the right-hand flank, committing Sujan Pereira to a save at the near post. And the ball finding Shering Doji, who thumps in the ball. And as the assistant referee shows, in just 3 minutes of added time, Sri Lanka only has 3 minutes to equalize. And for Bhutan, 3 long minutes to keep this lead and go into Bhutan with a hefty, healthy 1-0 win. Chencho with the ball. He's doing all the talking here from the onset. He's been harassing the Sri Lanka defense. The three Sri Lankan defenders are Subhash Madhushan, Thilina Suranda Bandara, and Tharindu Eranga for all this 90 minutes. For me, Sabir, he's been a really rock, a solid player for Bhutan in this match. He hasn't scored, but in the first half, he was the lone striker, but he has been playing really well, really troubling the Sri Lanka defenders. A huge shout out goes to the Bhutan fans who are at the Sugathadasa Stadium and also watching it live on www.thepapara.com all the way from Bhutan. Zarwan with the ball. He's taking too much time. He's isolated, but he weaves past 1-2 players. Chaturanga Sanjeev lays it back to some good bit of passing by Kavindu Ishan, but that final pass, like I said in the first half as well, that final telling pass in the attacking third is not going to plan. Sri Lankan fans here at the Sugathadasa Stadium are dumbstruck. They came in search of a win. Fazal Mohammed, almost in the dying seconds for Sri Lanka, equalizers. Almost. It goes past the far post, just over the upright. Heartbreaking scenes for the Sri Lankan fans here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Sujan Pereira comes way off his lines, out of the box, like Manuel Neuer. Clears that away for a goal kick. Almost in the dying seconds for Sri Lanka, equalizes. Almost. It goes past the far post, just over the upright. Heartbreaking scenes for the Sri Lankan fans here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. scored in Bhutan, but for Sri Lanka, they haven't been able to put that one final tailing pass into that attack in third. Sri Lanka kandayama saha Bhutan kandayama athara 2018 loka kusalane wenuen sudusakam laba ganime tarange Bhutan kandayama palam wate tarangen gole 1.0ක් ලෙස ජයග්‍රහණයක් ලබා ගන්නවා. For Sri Lanka, they haven't been able to put that one final telling pass into that attack in third. Sri Lanka kandayama saha Bhutan kandayama athara 2018 loka kusalane wenuen sudusakam laba ganime tarange Bhutan kandayama palam wate tarangen gole 1.0ක් ලෙස ජයග්‍රහණයක් ලබා ගන්නවා. For Sri Lanka, they haven't been able to put that one final telling pass into that attack in third. Full time here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Wonderful scenes, wonderful result for the Bhutanese. 1-0, they've won the first qualifying match. The first leg goal of the qualifying 2018 World Cup qualifier. They go into Bhutan with a 1-0 lead, 1-0 aggregate lead, and they will be favourites in the second leg as well. We're back in Bhutan. Full time here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Wonderful scenes, wonderful result for the Bhutanese. 1-0, they've won the first qualifying match. The first leg goal of the qualifying 2018 World Cup qualifier. They go into Bhutan with a 1-0 lead, 1-0 aggregate lead, and they will be favourites in the second leg as well. We're back in Bhutan. Full time here at the Sugathadasa Stadium. Wonderful scenes, wonderful. www.thepapra.com's live and exclusive coverage of Sri Lanka versus Bhutan 2018 World Cup qualifier. I'm here joined by a few Bhutan fans. Rodgay, what do you think about the performance today?
They played really great today, actually. They've never come up to this performance, but it was really great, and we wish them for the upcoming game in our country to play much better than this, and we could hope we can score more goals than this. Oh, Bhutan!
I'm just really happy that everything went well and the Bhutan won the match finally.
Exclusive coverage. That was the first choice. What do you think about this match?
Well, for a team that was like told to be the basement team, I think we did pretty well to show all of the people that we are up to the mark and we are doing well. Best of luck, Bhutan, for the upcoming match.
Well, the last time Bhutan won a match was against Afghanistan way back in 2008. It's been a long wait for a win and what a time to get that win.
Yeah, now it's a FIFA qualifier and then this win was like really awesome for us. And it came at a time that we, all of the supporters really wanted it to come.
Thank you. And y'all are here studying, is it?
Yes, all of us are medical students based in three different universities, Colombo, Kandy and Perutnina. And all of us, we came together and united up to the mark to like cheer our country.
So that was all the Bhutanese fans coming from Perutnina, Colombo and Ragama, who are studying here as medical students, who have come in their numbers to cheer the Bhutan side. And absolutely, the Bhutan players would have really loved the support here.
Everybody, they love the game and they love how the players they performed, how they performed well, and then I think it was a great moment to watch.
And talking back, how is the hospitality here in Sri Lanka?
It's really nice. The people are nice. They're friendly. So it's been a great moment in Sri Lanka too, studying here and living here.
Thank you, and all the best with your studies, mate. In their numbers, that was some of the Bhutan fans who were here in their numbers to support the Bhutan side. 1-0, they've won. Going, they will be going into second leg with a 1-0 lead. Sri Lanka will have all the. Will be really unfortunate for them, and they'll have to pull up their socks and play a really good game back in Bhutan. It would be alien conditions there as well. High altitude country there in Bhutan. So hope you've enjoyed the live and exclusive coverage on www.thepapari.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub. For me, that's it's now with Vijay Vikrama sharing the passion. We'll be going into second leg with a 1-0 lead. Sri Lanka will have all the. Will be really unfortunate for them, and they'll have to pull up their socks and play a really good game back in Bhutan. It would be alien conditions there as well. High altitude country there in Bhutan. So hope you've enjoyed the live and exclusive coverage on www.thepapari.com, Sri Lanka's number one sports hub. For me, that's it's now with Vijay Vikrama sharing the passion. We'll be going into second leg with a 1-0 lead. Sri Lanka will have all the. Will be really unfortunate for them, and they'll have to pull up their socks. And